In this presentation, students will show you few of the units of your third and fourth year laboratory courses. They are located in the pilot plant, in which you will go to learn about the theory and the operating of units in chemical engineering.
Filtration is a unit used to remove particles or other matter from a liquid by sending it through a filter paper, a membrane, or a bed of particles. It is essentially what you do when you strain pasta from water. Filtration is commonly used in the wastewater industry to remove contaminants or solids from wastewater and let the clean water pass through to then be reused. Filtration is a unit that you're going to learn about in your fourth year of studies, and you will also apply that knowledge in your fourth year lab.
Fluidization is commonly used within chemical engineering when you want a good mix between a solid and a liquid. You can have two or three phase fluidization based on a combination of fluids and solid particles. One of the common applications for fluidization is within the food processing industry, where you can use it to dry foods or freeze foods. As a chemical engineering student at the University of Ottawa, you'll start using the equations behind fluidization and seeing fluidization in your second year fluid mechanics class.
Absorption is a very important gas-liquid separation process. In this unit, a certain solute in a gas stream is removed into a liquid stream by sending the two together into a column that is filled with packing. Absorption is a unit that is commonly used to extract CO2 from the combustion of fossil fuels to limit greenhouse gas emissions. You will learn about this unit in your third year of studies, and then you will apply that knowledge in your fourth year lab.
Distillation columns are one of the most commonly used units within chemical engineering. They work by separating components based on their relative boiling points. One of the common industries that distillation columns are used in is the petroleum industry, where they're used to separate hydrocarbons in the production of fuels. As a student in chemical engineering, you'll start to see the theories and equations behind distillation columns as early as your second year in chemical engineering.